My name is Jordan Myers, and I'm a graduate student at the Yale School of Medicine in the laboratories of Patrick Lusk and Jörg Beversdorf. They're both in cell biology. Patrick is a traditional biologist, and Jörg is a trained physicist. I'm from a very small town. I'm talking like 1,200 people, high school graduating class of about 60 people. I grew up along the Erie Canal. It's a very large farming community known for potatoes and corn there. And I'm kind of the black sheep of my family. They're all contractors. They work with their hands. They build houses. One of my uncles is a chimney sweep. And what got me interested in science were the few, you know, science shows that were on during my childhood, like Bill Nye the Science Guy. And then, you know, you watch things like The Magic School Bus. Because the area is so small, the local colleges there actually had large science fairs for all of these surrounding areas. And it's really wonderful to have that curiosity and wonder when you're that young. One of the great things about being here is the camaraderie that you have. You definitely have a great support system in the people that you work with. If I pool both my labs, there are people from all parts of the globe. But I also think it's great because now in science, it seems like the collaborative efforts that are occurring in the fields. You're blending so many wonderful things together, biology with physics, physics with chemistry. I mean, engineering, you know, gets tied in there, and of course math, obviously. But if you have not just one interest, but you have so many, you can typically get many flavors of wonderful things right in one project. My thesis project is actually looking at what's called the nuclear pore complex. And basically what that is it's kind of like the Panama Canal of the cell. Basically, it allows the nucleus, or the control center of the cell, to communicate with the rest of the cell. And that's done because it regulates the passage of molecules between the two spaces. And what I do is I use light microscopy. I shine lasers at things to make them glow different colors. And that allows me to look inside the cell and actually see this structure. The control center of the cell is communicating with the rest of the cell. If that breaks down, you can imagine all sorts of problems going wrong. Definitely my favorite part of the research is actually having something go well when I'm imaging on the microscope. After you're on it for a while, it's like, you know, you're taking images for hours, and then you just kind of sit back and you realize, nobody else has actually seen this before. This is the first time this has been seen in the world. And then you kind of sit there and you have this moment of wonder. And being able to create that is wonderful because it's science, but it's also, it feels like it's art.